Hello and welcome to Watkins Glen in C Open. Finally, I've been waiting to do this one this week, but every time I went to sign up, there was no one participating because I'm a decrepit gargoyle and decided to stay up way late for my races. But we're actually here at a decent time today. Let me adjust my volume a little bit. Okay, and we got 30 people signed up, I think it was. I am unfortunately the number 2, which means my road ironing is probably going to take a hit here, because I've never been all too great with the stock cars on road courses, and my road ironing is a little inflated because of all the rookie Mazdas and Formula Vs I do and stuff. So. Well, at least it'll be more accurate. It'll more accurately represent my actual talent level on road, so. I don't expect much out of the finish here. Just gonna try to keep it on the track and, you know, probably be, I don't know, medium speed? Not quite sure. So, we'll give it our best shot. Got our setup here from Old School Racing Forums, as usual, OSR. And as is typically the case with stock cars on road courses, you gotta be super easy on the throttle when zooming up, gas pedal down, or else it gets real loose. So, gonna be on the lookout for that. And, yeah, just trying to keep it on the solid stuff. Seeing what we could do. And right now, we're seeing what we can do in qualifying, as I'm sure you noticed. You can kind of get a little unsettled while shifting, so I found that it's good to try to do your shifting while in a straight line, if possible. Because it gets kind of weird if you're in the middle of a corner and you start shifting and it kind of unsettles the vehicle. So, trying to navigate that, and you can actually, I don't know if it's my setup or just how it works here, but notice that you can actually get the car turning a little better once you get on the throttle. So I've used that to my advantage a little bit when I'm going through the corners, but obviously, like I said, you gotta make sure that you're being delicate. It's fine balance. Not the greatest lap first time through, but kind of just getting my road course legs. Oh, whoa. Okay, well, still stumbling on those legs, I guess, because that was not good. This lap's going to be terrible. So I guess that's going to be my lap. Told you it was not going to be great. Whew. So. Oh, well. This is my first race here at the new Watkins Glen, which I didn't even realize was given to everyone who already had Watkins Glen, which is fantastic, because it's a very much needed update that everyone was very excited for, and it was a long time coming. So, you know, usually when they do such a big update, you think you'd have to buy it again, but not the case. So that was very nice of iRacing. Thank you, iRacing. We're just gonna wheel around a little bit more, get a little more practice, because while I did get plenty of practice ahead of time, it was not today, because I practiced two separate times in an anticipation of doing a race, but then no one signed up. So I have to kind of get back into the groove of it today specifically, which maybe impacted my qualifying times. So I think I'm going to enjoy taking a little extra time here. We'll see if everyone signs up or everyone is ready to race and it'll kick us out. But until then, we'll get a couple more corners in. You can really use up these curbs more at New Watkins Glen, because you can see they're kind of like flattened out more, which is nice. And I know you can go wider off some of these runoff areas than you used to be able to. Like, you can go off here and it's not an off track. But I guess the way I run it, maybe I need to learn to take that the carousel a little more aggressively, because the way I run it, I don't find myself going out there and using the whole track. So I might be able to take it a little faster if I do that, but as of right now, I've not been using up that part of the track. We are in 10th. That's probably not good. Oh, well, okay, we're doing okay. We're ahead of some people. I'm looking at the standings, not the track, so. It is open, so we will have to get fuel at one point, and, you know, yellow flags, unlike real NASCAR, do follow typical road racing rules, so there's no full course cautions. There will be local cautions. So that means guaranteed green flag pit stops. That's exciting. And scary. But I did also practice that as well. If we have enough time, which I don't think we will. Oh, we got 2 minutes. I guess I should remember that it is a road course, so you get extra qualifying time. I will go ahead and practice a stop right now, then. This place is interesting when entering the pits. Green flag, because the line is very... comes up on you really quick. And you gotta be ready to be at the right speed. Which I believe, if I remember correctly, is 45? So you gotta, like, come down here, and then look, it's right here, immediately. So make sure it's a 40. Okay, good to know. So don't speed. Talking to myself, and I'm suggesting that to anyone else that might try this. Don't speed if you're gonna be coming in here, because it's very easy to do, because you could be going a lot faster than 40, and that line comes up quick, so. Tip of the day, don't get penalties. Wow, bet you never thought of that, huh?
3, 2, 1.
Oof.
Box now.
But, yeah. Love Watkins Glen. Classic track. And, probably the road course that I actually have, you know, counting all racing games I've ever played, probably the one that I've raced the most, just because, you know, NASCAR has always raced Watkins Glen, so, you know, the old NASCAR games and all that stuff, I've become familiar with this track in very different forms, because, I mean, something tells me that maybe the mid-2000s NASCAR games weren't quite as realistic physics-wise as iRacing, but, still familiar with the layout, general braking points, that kind of thing, so... I enjoy running it. It's kind of like a fast-paced road course. I always liked it. And I enjoy watching him run it in real life, too, so. Good place. Alright, we're kicked out. And, new year, new paint, as has been the case with a lot of my series. We got the Cracker Barrel truck. Sure. Woo! I don't know. I just kind of picked one that looked kind of nice, I guess. I don't really have much to say about it. It's just what the scheme I chose is. It's not mine. Picked it on Trading Paints. Looked okay. We're starting 10th out of 30, so that's better than I thought that it was going to get, I guess. But gotta survive. And that's what we will try to do.
Full set, turn one. Fourth gear.
Hopefully we do not die.
Right,
got our crew chief ready. For fuel, 2 sets of tires. Don't think we're going to be using both of those.
Much less right and left at the same time.
We don't have enough data for that.
I assume we're just going to cut it right in half, maybe? Or maybe strategically pit, like if we got a group of cars or trucks in front of us. Maybe pit so we don't have to deal with that, get slowed by down by them. Just gonna kind of feel it out for the strategy in this one, but since there's no yellow flags, presumably, I guess halfway is where you want to go. I don't know. I don't know if I've ever done an open race at a road course before. It was a bit of a new experience strategy-wise for me. Not too familiar with how it's gonna go. I am anticipating lots of spins.
Running, but I run 62 for the brake bias.
Lots of spins early on, especially as the tires are cold and guys are not quite in the zone yet. Driving around, going to be driving around people, and maybe making mistakes.
You have two additional sets of
getting on the throttle too quickly and stuff. So, hopefully, A, we don't do that ourselves. B, we don't end up running into someone that does that themselves. And C, we don't get run over from behind. All of those are very possible. So,
thank you.
We need to follow car number 10.
Top 10 would be fine. If I can qualify 10th and then finish in the top 10, I think that'd be pretty good.
Sorry about that. I must hit my.
But I really don't know what to expect. I really don't. Bit of a wild card here. And I just hope that it'll be a fun race. That's all I'm hoping for. I'm just glad I was able to do this race at all, because for a minute there it was looking like.
But let it be one. There's a potential.
I never raced at times whenever people were actually signing up for this, so.
You gotta be pushing the whole entire race for this thing to run out of gas.
Oh! They're saying that it will not run out of gas.
Yeah, I mean, push.
Well, I have run out right at the line before.
That's new information.
I know what you're talking about. I'm running Sunoco racing fuel, not gas.
Okay. Well, that's news to me. Apparently, we will not run out of gas in an open race?
We haven't got that data.
Maybe they're being tricky, but it sure doesn't sound like it. We'll find out. I got my crew chief ready, and we'll see what the fuel economy's looking like, but that's interesting. That's a different twist in it, so that would mean no pitting at all. Because I'm not pitting for tires. Alright. Let's see. Don't think tire spin's gonna be a thing. Maybe. Let me test again in a moment here. First did it. Oh, I guess we can go this way. Nice. No penalties before the start of the race, I suppose, so that makes sense. Just come on through there. Look at me learning all kinds of new things. Got a lot of white color trucks up here. Like the base color. Including my own, although mine's kind of like a kind of beige-ish. It's got a little bit of a, like a brownish tint to it. Well, that's red and black. A couple American flags in front of us too. Oh, they must be on a team. DSP Racing. So they're probably sharing their setup and all that. All right. Long pace lap, obviously, because it's a full road course, so. Got lots of time to think about things that don't matter. Like how it's cold in my room right now. Kinda wish we had the heat on. So. Things will start heating up when this race gets intense. Won't be thinking about that. We'll be thinking about, I think that we might actually be spinning the tires a bit. Let me be easy on this throttle.
Ready, going okay. Green.
Good to know. Get thinking about going.
Okay, the pace car is in. Focus. Green, green, green.
All right.
Right side.
Can't really use that runoff anymore. You'll get it off track, so not looking to do that.
Stay on the left. Clear on the right.
Try to get single file. Ooh, got someone getting a little unsettled up there.
Good start, mate. Nice one.
Kinda easy. Hopefully don't get run over from behind. Just don't want to make any dumb mistakes. I'm always kind of the most timid one on the track. Early in a race. I don't really push very hard off the start. So, I'll let this guy by. All right, that's fine. We're still alive after lap one. That's worth something. Not much, but something. Kind of like a 25 ticket prize at the arcade. You get like a finger trap thing. That's what that's worth. Something, but not much. Maybe an airhead. Or Tootsie Roll. God, on the rumble strips, probably didn't want to do that. We're gonna let one by.
Keep to the right.
Because I'm pretty slow.
Clear on the left.
Yeah, I guess you don't really want to hit those rumble strips. Oh my god, that guy runs through there fast. Okay.
Car right.
Can have it.
Clear.
He took the bus stop or whatever you call it much faster than I did, so. Just let him have it. Playing long term here. I'm just, I'm not aggressive enough. This is saying that I will need fuel, so I don't know what to believe anymore. Really gonna have to pay attention to that. Maybe once tires start wearing off, maybe we'll be off throttle more. That's when it'll even out, but right now it's saying I need like 2 gallons. I'd much rather not have to worry about that, because I think all of my focus really should be on this. But, you know, no crew chiefs, so. Yeah, you can see, like, my lap times right now. My race pace is much lower than my, like, qualifying pace and stuff, because I'm just, I'm being really nervous. Too nervous. Almost assuredly. But I don't want to spin out. I just don't. It's not a thing that's on my to-do list, so. Where are we, 11th? Is that correct? Remember, we got past that lap. Alright, yeah, 11. Need to not hit those rumble strips. Alright. Gotta be a little faster now. Gotta get a little more comfortable and start gaining a little speed, maybe.
No pressure back here, Robert. I just want to get out of this without an instant point.
Yeah, I'm just happy to be here. This is pretty fun. It's very difficult, in my opinion, but pretty fun.
Sector 1 is 0.9.
So, I'm just happy I can participate, even if I don't finish too well. I've got a little sideways there. I was easy on the throttle, too, I felt like. I still got kind of sideways. Still hitting that rumble strip. Or the curb or whatever you want to call it. Oh, there's someone over there. Someone has gone off. So here's a spot. We're in the top 10 now. Like I said, that'd be good for me. I'm good with the top 10 if I can get that, so no pressure on me right now. If I can keep these guys behind me and get this top 10, I'm feeling A-okay. I definitely feel like I could be more aggressive on throttle, especially because when you are on throttle, like I said, it kind of turns the truck more. So if I had all the confidence in the world, I could probably pull off going through these corners a little faster. But, yeah, see, when I try, that's what happens. So, not gonna try to do that again. This can be delicate. And maybe consistency will bring us somewhere by the end of this thing. Somewhere other than the back of the field. Oh, we're not at the back. We're in the top third of the field, being that we're in 10th in a 30-truck roster. I don't feel too bad about that, even if I am the 2. But like I said, that's an inflated road eye rating making that happen.
Thank you for paying attention, 30.
Alright, what's fuel saying now?
0.27 gallons.
Okay, so that went from 2 gallons needed to 0.7, so it does sound like we are not going to need fuel. That's very, very good. That's good to hear. I'm really glad I have crew chief, because I would have assumed that I would need fuel, and that's not the case. And they did mention it before the race, but had I not had crew chief, I might not have believed them. So.
Really, was that necessary?
We've got unnecessary moves happening. Not sure where. Seeing any free spots ahead of us, so maybe not so much in front of us, but behind us. Got the 30 truck ahead of us. It is a single split, and they are the highest number, so might be having some struggles. Hopefully they'll give us some room. Oh, we got people yelling. Are you letting us by?
Car on. Clear.
Okay.
Sector 3 is 1.1 seconds off the pace.
Thank you, 30. I can't even, like, take a second to talk on the mic, because it makes me miss my points. It's like every moment you're trying to do something. Ooh. Whether it's shifting or...
I keep screwing up the bus stop tonight for some reason.
Whether it's shifting or, like, positioning your truck for the next corner.
Jack
kind of messed up there.
Get a little bit closer to that wall, right?
There's always something you're preparing for or working on. Here, it feels like.
There's just something about that first curve where if you don't hit it dead on straight and square up the front end with it, it's just gonna mess up your lap time.
Yep, and I just, for whatever reason, I can't see this hit it quite right.
Alright, let's get in the zone here. See if we can put in good laps. I'd like to see what I could do. Tires are a little warmer now. I don't know how much that matters. I imagine it matters somewhat. But it just always feels like it's on ice to me. But, yeah, let's see what we can do. Might be some silent time, just gonna be honest, because lots of concentration going on. Hello, 26, pardon me.
Dang, I get over
right there. Calling you left. Clear.
We got the front just now, 3.0.
You always seem to find
mess that up again, unfortunately.
The worst points.
Yep, it's just not luck.
Well, I thought I was going for a faster lap this time. It's not really happening. I'm so nervous. I don't have the confidence to really just drive it hard and everything, because I don't want to spin out so much. So I'm like a second off all my best times. Got those race nerves. We kind of got this number one, though. You're kind of on our horizon. I don't know what the deficit's, the relative's been looking like, but I know he's been pretty around that 3 second mark.
Thank you, appreciate it.
This is one of those races where my hands are gonna hurt afterward because I'm squeezing the wheel so tight.
There, I hit it that time.
A bit of an early shift there. That was almost too early. So it kind of worked out, I guess.
Thanks, bud.
No problem, buddy.
No problem, guys.
27 coming up. Hopefully we'll catch him in a decent spot. Not too bad. Had to go out and exit that corner a little softer, but not too bad. Okay. I love this section. It's truck. It's super light. It's super loose, but it's pretty fun to run through there, especially if you happen to do it real well, which I don't often do. But if you fly through there, it feels really good. We're approaching a lap truck at the worst part to catch someone on the track. Through the bus stop there. Lost a little bit of time waiting for them to get through, but we did it safely, and that's what matters most. And we are catching this one, so that's good news. See if that trend continues. I tend to forget that short shifting on road courses isn't always such a bad idea. Because you can get on the gas a little harder, so there might be different ways I can be... Oh, don't go off track. There could be ways that I could be actually going faster. Like, what if I short shift here? No! Nope. Let me not change things during the race. Oh, that didn't work out so well. I thought maybe, okay, lower RPMs, maybe that means I can get the gas down a little harder through there. And maybe that's still true, but it didn't work out so well for me there, so.
Thank you, Mario.
Let me leave that experimentation for practice, maybe. Yeah,
cool.
Yeah, I don't really use the whole track there. I don't know if I'm losing time by doing that, but...
Alright, 15, can you move out of the way? Thank you.
I always feel like I'm pretty slow through that final corner, too. I always feel like I can take that a little better.
Thank you.
Like, people are being polite, that's cool. Except for that one guy that got really mad, but he might have had a good reason. Oh, my hands hurt already. We're only approaching halfway right now. I think we caught the one a lot through that bus stop. Maybe they take it much softer. I don't know. Of course, one of the more difficult spots on the track. I feel like anytime you get a chicane or bus stop or anything, there's usually pretty difficult to navigate properly.
Third.
Yeah, he got a better runoff on the final corner there. I can probably push it a little harder.
Thank you, 28.
Catching you one. Better look out. We seem pretty similar on speed. Kind of seems like. And yeah, it looks like we take this bus stop better than they're able to. Alright, half a second behind him. Wonder how we're gonna make a pass.
Thank you, 29.
I had to push a little harder through there that time. Still looks like they did it better, but I think I was maybe a little better than last time, at least that time.
Yes, sir.
Oh! Yeah, short shifted, I think, by accident. Or, whatever you call it. There's a name for it, I don't remember right now. But, it's whenever you shift down too soon, and it really upsets the vehicle.
Thanks, Brad.
If you do that too hard, you can actually blow your engine. There, it looked like it just upset him, and luckily for him, he didn't spin it out. And luckily for us, made the pass process a lot easier. Nice. Maybe we really did intimidate him. But I don't think, unless we got some wrecks coming up at any point, I don't think we're moving forward anymore. Because if I saw that correctly, that... Ooh! Got on the gas too hard. That guy ahead of us is like 13 seconds ahead.
Stay on the left, clear on the right.
So sure about that. We got the 7 coming up on us fast. He's got a lot of speed apparently, so we're gonna have to watch him. Might have ourselves a gain a spot, lose a spot situation here. Pass the 1, get passed by the 7.
Alright, Colton, the next car is Taylor.
Thanks, Ben.
Yeah, he's gaining. So he's catching us, but I think someone ahead of us must have spun or something, because suddenly we do see them.
Did he get wrecked again?
Overdrove it a bit, because
no,
I was looking at him, peeking to the inside. I gotta make sure I'm hitting my marks and not thinking about him. Because if he's not poking his nose in, then I gotta run my normal line. Can't let myself be intimidated. Really kick that throttle and get it turning. It's really interesting. I feel like these road courses and stock cars, you can drive cars on edge like no other place. And that's where you get like those road course ringers that are just so good at it, because they can drive it on that edge and just push it beyond belief. And I, not so much. I, not so much, can do that.
That lap time was 16.1.
I drove it again. No, did the same thing as last lap. Looking at him peeking. I think he knows it worked last time. It's pressing L2 to intimidate. We're in 8th, by the way. I think someone crashed.
I think you're not coming down right there.
Thank you, appreciate it, guys.
Either I got through that section slower this time, or he got through it faster, because last lap it felt like I gained on him through there, and here I feel like he either maintained or even caught up through the bus stop, so. Something to note.
Now, Robert, but I'm back and forth. I'm coming for you.
We got a nice group of cars in front of us here.
I better turn on my little nitrous bottle.
15.9, sector 1 is 1.1, off the pace.
We're really getting chased. I'm doing my best to maintain this spot. So he may catch us. Oh, my hand. Especially my left hand is really hurting right now.
I heard they're trying to put it in the next gen car, so might be here sooner or later.
Spot, we're okay. I messed that up. I was really delicate on the throttle, so we're gonna give this to him.
Clear on the left.
Fine. We might get it back still. I don't know if he's much faster and he just was being patient behind us. But we'll see if we can keep up and maybe we can fight back. Not gonna do anything dumb, but maybe we still have a shot at this yet. Might learn a thing, maybe. Oh! Don't do that. I already knew not to do that. Very easy to do, though. Getting back on the throttle.
Thanks, Frank.
Gotta stop gripping the wheel so tight. I think it's actually affecting me at this point. I'm just so nervous gripping the wheel, it's like actually causing hand fatigue. This curb's up. He's going a little wider through there. Maybe I should be doing that. Getting a better runoff. That seems to be working pretty well for him. I might try that next lap. Run a little higher and through the carousel.
Thank you for holding your brakes.
Thanks, my friend.
Alright, I'm happy with how this is going so far, though. 9th place at the moment. About what I was hoping for.
I'll go wide here.
And I believe 0x at the moment as well, so. At the moment. I have to check to see what the fuel's saying at this point. I just don't have the carousel figured out too well. Slow through here. Courtney.
Woo!
This feels like anaerobic exercise. Hold my breath so much. It's raining. Oh no! Whoop! Number 7! We've gained our spot back. Like I said, really easy to do. Half a turn one there. It's probably... Well, I was gonna say, that's probably like one of the easiest spots to hit the gas too hard and spin out on this track, but I'll be honest, every single moment getting on the gas at this track is perilous. In stock cars. Ooh, ooh. Sound like an owl. Ooh, ooh. Got Red Bull in front of us.
Thank you.
Number 14, he is a lap down. Or more. Okay, he's gonna hold his line there, I guess. I lift off. Okay. I wonder if the 7's going to be able to just catch right back up to us. I do think he's a little bit faster. But maybe if we can go get some nice laps, maybe he won't have enough time to do it. I have not done a lap on the iRacing setup. I've only done laps.
Got about 5 laps of fuel. That's more than enough finish. 0.4 gallons.
More than enough, are you sure?
Man, why are you in that shifting corner like freaking 20 miles an hour?
Car stopped ahead.
That's someone on the lead lap.
You took me out earlier and you just rear-ended me and you're an idiot.
Oh boy. Gather my thoughts. Thinking about fuel and thinking about the guy that wrecked in front of us.
Which
is on our lap. Think about how I'm getting around every corner because it's always scary. Angry guys in the middle of the track with a broken truck. Oh my god, quit yelling and being on the apex with a broken truck.
And you should have just waved me by with all the
damage. Oh boy, he's not thinking straight right now because he's angry. He's not thinking about how he's on the apex or even on the track at all right now because there's no reason to be.
Well, that means you're not a very good driver because everybody else got by me just fine. And now I'm not putting it because of you. I'm gonna race, dude. I'm not supposed to stop.
Don't know what happened, so I don't know who's actually at fault there, but probably don't be on the apex with a slow broken truck if you can avoid it. I will say that, at the very least. 7's coming back, man. 2.6. I think we have enough fuel, though. It said about 5 left, but we had like 5.4 when it said that. I think we're going to be just fine, so I'm choosing not to worry about that. Because here it will be 4 laps to go, and we got 4.2, so it's going to be just enough. So that's good.
Okay, Colton, you got about 4 laps of fuel left.
Overdrove it. That's my 1x of the race.
Cut the track.
Man, I wish I had noticed I was going to go off sooner, because if I'm going to get a 1x, I might as well commit and get some time. We're bleeding time pretty bad at this point.
Yellow flag.
Oh, is that another lead lap person wrecking? Not sure. I thought I saw, yeah, that 5. I think they're back going again, though. Clearly, if they're all the way up there, they're faster than us, so. Unless they got damage.
Why is it always me having to slam on brakes in the bus stop and spinning out because I have to avoid a lap car.
I don't know, you lapped me a couple times, and I kind of noticed you usually don't know how to lap cars, so, lapping cars is hard to
do. This 26 is really mad at the lead lap, guys.
I thought you were pretty much early.
Oh! Rear tire's getting kind of hot.
Lap cars don't stay in the preferred line, either.
We estimate 3 laps of fuel left.
Hey, time, 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 time!
Buddy, I think it's just best to keep the mouth shut.
That was some intelligent commentary.
Two more, let's go.
Let's see. FedEx ahead of us. Yeah, that five's just, making his way back further. I think 7's gonna pass us before we gonna finish this thing. Yeah, these warnings about fuel, they're gonna be okay.
Not big deal.
Car right, clear.
We'll try to hold them off. We got 2 laps to try to hold them off, but not gonna run my good finish or his good finish. By overdriving and making a mistake. So. I mean, I consider this a good finish. I don't know if he does, but I consider this a good finish.
9 to 10,
88. Hey, we gained some on him there.
Thank
you, whoever that was. I couldn't read it out.
Try getting a runoff. See how that feels.
You have about 1 lap of fuel.
Not so great. I don't think that worked out so well. Oh no! Danger! Danger! Danger, danger, danger. Okay. We're gonna have to run. We're gonna have to run real good. You wanna keep this spot?
White flag, last lap. You've only got enough fuel for this lap. That lap time was 116.3.
I'm pushing.
Thank you, sir.
Whew. Not much to say right now. Trying to keep this spot. Oh, don't hurt me.
Still there.
No!
Still there.
He got me. He made me nervous. I dove in there.
Chicken flag, chicken flag.
Nice job getting me at the end there, 7. I got loose off the final corner. Well, that was fun. 8th place! Alright, got the top 10 I was hoping for.
Would have had another good battle there, Roger, if lap cars weren't a
thing. Ooh, I'm sweating. Oh, and we're out of fuel now. That's funny. Out of fuel, because we just barely made it. So, no more driving around. Let's see how close that finish was. If the, oh, I thought the game was going to crash there for a second. Alright. camera weird because I was showing off the new paint. Right, something like this maybe. Sure, that'll be good enough. No, I don't like that actually. Does this look weird? I feel like this looks weird. Whatever. See that final a little bit. So, I was actually planning on taking this pretty slow because I figured, you know, I could just kind of park it and he wouldn't get a chance around me, but he really went in there hard and actually took the run and went around, and he got so close to me here, I got nervous and kind of throttled up a little bit too much, and that got me loose. I'm like, oh no. And then we just had a drag race. Just got me. Oh well. Not a big difference between 7th and 8th. But there is some difference between wrecking and not wrecking, so at least I didn't do that. We got ourselves a 1x in total. Pretty proud of that. Just went off track one time. And happy with the finish. Let's see how everything went for everyone else. Let's do a chopper. Lap one, probably gonna get loose here. Side by side, not too bad. That could have been a bad one though. That part of the track can get blocked really easily. I had an ARCA race in the past where there was just one big clog there. Oh man, that was a missed breaking point. Yikes. They got stuck in the wall, I think. Yeah, they just missed the breaking point real bad. Oof. Just get stuck in the tire barrier. That's rough. I can get loose off here. Yeah, really easy. That's probably recoverable, though. I get that turned around and keep going. Looked okay to me. Might have gotten off track. Might have gotten too far over. This guy finished ahead of us. Oh, wow. He almost hit the inside barrier there. Oh, man. I kind of want to see how close that was. Oh, he did hit it. Wow, that could have been really bad for him. Just gave it a tiny little scrape. Yeah, this is the guy that beat us. He was obviously pretty fast. I feel bad that a guy that spun multiple times beat us, but I mean, if he's faster, he's got plenty of time to make it up. So did he get that inside wall as well? I think so. I think he got it and it unsettled him. I'm sure he's able to spin that around real quick. He's got plenty of room to do so. He used to be. That was not paved. And we would have finished ahead of him. Because he would have been stuck in that sand for a while. Oh, that's one of those shifts. What is this, a team here? We got the same, paint scheme. I'm still not happy with this. I'm sorry. Still not happy with this camera so much. What we got? Far chase. Let's do, like, farther away and... Yeah, let's do it like this. That's good. Sorry, I tinker with that. So they shifted down too much, or like one extra gear probably here. Spinning around. And then the 22 trying to avoid him ends up off as well. I don't know if they're a team or if they just happen to have the same paint scheme, but they went in as a pair that corner. A little cluster here. Ooh, that's a tough spot because the 26 was going real slow. I think maybe even letting him by. I think even netcode played a tiny bit of a role there. It's an unfortunate situation. It just seemed like a lot of indecision and left some guys bumping into each other. Gonna get loose off of one. Yep. Ooh, that's a pretty firm hit to the front end. Still going though. Another guy that finishes ahead of us. He really got going quick though again after that. I think he just got too much of this curb. And he's the one that's like, why am I always the one that reaches the slow cars? And he's not. We actually all have to deal with it, but... That was a really bad spot to catch up to someone. What am I hearing? I'm hearing something behind this guy, like someone really loud. Someone overdrive this? No. I don't know why, it got really loud for a second. I thought someone was like missing their braking point or something. Kinda like that. Uh-oh. 30 was an innocent bystander there. Lots of very polite lap cars in this race, I will say that. The guys that we were getting around, they all lifted very well and were given space, so I very much appreciate all of that. Didn't really have anyone, you know, trying to take too wide or anything, so that was very nice. That was very nice. One extra shift there, maybe. Bringing it around. It's bad for the people that catch him, too. That was just a bad decision to go to the inside. I guess maybe not. The 20 really should be sitting still, not trying to gas it up, because I think maybe the truck on the inside would have made it, but I think they really should have just gone outside. That would have been the safe route to take, clearly. I love New York! It says, sorry, yawning. This guy did finish out of us, right? Yeah. I was wondering, because he is in 7th right here. We were behind him at this point. I was just wondering. Maybe getting a tiny tap of that wall. Uh-oh, this is scary. Yeah. So... bad spot for the 6 to be in, because you've got two guys. Oh, these are all lead lap guys, actually. These guys are all fighting. So he kind of just... I don't think he should be trying to make a pass through here, to be honest. Unless you're really confident. I mean, maybe that's not the issue. He probably is. He was confident enough to try it, but... unless you really are able to stick it. And he kind of just got the truck unsettled by taking this curb so much. And runs into the truck there. This guy, I think we did end up finishing ahead of, didn't we? Yeah, I think he had more troubles eventually. Because at this point in the race, we're still, we're just past halfway. Oh! There was a free spot, because that probably is a broken truck. Not gonna say anything more about that one. Wrangler. Can't wrangle it in. Looks like it should be another quick turnaround. There's basically no sand to get stuck in anymore at Watkins Glen, the new updated one, so... a lot of these spins and things, guys can get going really quick. I don't have to go beaching it for a while. I was 14, taking a later braking point than the 24. Letting someone by while taking the preferred line. That's probably because they just came through here, yeah. So, 30's probably trying his best to get out of the way, but it's a tough spot. Probably should have just gone wide there, but maybe it looked like they were poking out, and then he kind of just fails to keep it on the bottom there. But doesn't look like much harm done, unless he gets him here. No. Just a little tap. More loose on exit there. Yeah. This is 7. That looks like a misshift. Or maybe just got... yeah, the way it kind of lurches for a second there. I don't know if you can see that, but it kind of like shifts to the left a little bit. I think that's because he shifted down one too many times or too early. And even though we get by and we couldn't hold them off in the end. Saw that and we're like, oh no. So I made it safely around him. Kept it on the track. P4 here. Ooh, that's a new one. Just being a little too wide through this section, maybe. I'm curious. I don't know what it means, but I'm going to check my tires. 87, 82. Okay. Yeah, that's usually the case. Wow, the left sides are worse. That's usually the case at road courses. Your rears are actually burn off more because you're burning them up when you're getting back on the throttle. So when you're gassing it up, you're spinning those rear tires. And so you do want to kind of be nice to them when you're gassing up, if possible. So you spin the tires less. Not quite like normal ovals where it's the right front being a problem. Oh, okay, well, I'm going to purchase this one. Is this the guy that was freaking out? Yeah. He needs to take a little break, I think. He's had too many bad races in a row and let his temper get to him. So, problem here is that the lap car is on the apex going really, really slow in front of the lead lap guy. Could the... Wow, he's going really slow. I mean, could the lead lap guy have gone around him safely? Yeah, but I don't think he'd anticipate him to be going that slow. I mean, that's really slow. I mean, we're going 94 here. He's going, what, 71. That's like a 25. It's almost a 25 mile per hour difference. And he's, like, slamming on his brakes. Like, if you're going to be that slow, you have to get out of the way. And then this is just not acceptable. That's not acceptable at all. So. Alright. Yeah, I'm gonna have to protest this one. We don't need people like that on the track, to be honest. Completely unwarranted. So. There goes another 10 minutes of my life. I'm gonna have to protest. Anyway, moving on. So barely a little wall tap there. Only guy that ever reaches people in the bus stop going slow. Allegedly. Reaching guys in the bus stop. A little hard on gas, maybe got loose. And same thing there. Maybe got a little bit too much of the curb and that and contributed. That's rough. It's such a bummer for these guys later in the race, especially this guy who looks like he has a clean truck. Oh no, are you kidding me? He got stuck? iRacing's gotta not let that happen because there's no reason he should get stuck here. He can get this back going and probably still finish a little better. But because he gets stuck, he probably has to tow here in a second. And that's not even fair. Because I don't remember even seeing this guy all too often in the incidents. And now, because he gets stuck in the wall, in the collision, now he's got a toe. That's not very good either. I'm protest. Now I got to protest iRacing. But so there's your second place guy celebrating. Is it because his teammate got first? Is it this DSP who got first? Yeah, DSP, whatever that is. So they're on a team. This DSP2, did they have that good of a race? Nah, but 1-2. Alright. Their team has it figured out. But that'll be it for our incidents. So, I got myself the top 10 I was hoping for, and I moved forward during the race. Both things to feel good about, and my 1X just went off one time. So, yeah, kind of what I expected from myself in this one. Just, you know, slow going for the most part, you know, average laps, keeping it on the track. And that got us our top 10. So, feeling pretty good about it. And it was a fun race. Watkins Glen is always fun. So, I hope you enjoyed watching. I enjoyed driving it. And we had a kind of a close finish at the air. Got at the end there. Got pretty exciting. So, alright. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. Oh, and Happy New Year. This is my first race of the new year. Even though it'll be coming out a few days later. But Happy New Year. See you next time.